everyone. I hope all you are doing very good in your life. Today in this video we are going to cover module number 4, that is quantum mechanics. Actually ee module nalli erdu concept ide or erdu chapter ide. One is quantum mechanics itself and another one is laser. So once we deal with quantum mechanics, then we'll start with laser. So before we are going to see the quantum mechanical concept, before that we must understand what are the concepts we are learning in this module. Nothing but what are the concepts there in VTU syllabus and yavyava concept ninda estest marks na now expect maadabodu adliyodalli ee part nolaga nodona. So first ge that is introduction to quantum mechanics. In this part we are going to learn the introductory part for a quantum mechanics. Yava reason igoskara we need another branch of science or another branch of physics. That situation we are going to see in this introductory part. First of all, as per VTU syllabus yava concept ninda yava question nu expect madu avashyakate illa. Okay, so hagid mele next concept is wave nature of a particle. So wave nature of a particle nalli we are going to study the particle when it behave as a wave or a wave when it behave as a particle. So e concept mele we can expect 2 marks question, 4 marks question and 6 marks question. So these are the 3 possibilities. We can expect 2 marks question as a definition, we can expect 4 marks question with little bit explanation, and we can expect a 6 marks question so little bit derivation part. Okay, so let's start with the next concept, that is Heisenberg uncertainty principle. Definitely 2 marks question, that's it, 2 marks question from this concept. And then in the case of application which is related to Heisenberg uncertainty, here we can expect the 8 to 10 marks derivation, that is non-existence of the electron. Definitely one question may get in your VTU syllabus exam, that is for 8 to 10 marks, 10 marks question. And then next one is also for Schrodinger time independent wave equation. That is also a derivation, we can say that is for 8 to 10 marks question. And then if we see here significance of the wave function, normalization and probability density, these are the concept. With respect to significance of the wave function, they may ask you for 4 to 6 marks question. Normalization and probability density, that is for 2 marks definition. And then the derivation, once again we have derivation, that is particle in a box, one derivation, and energy eigen values of a particle in a box, this is also another set of derivation. So these two derivation may come for 8 to 10 marks. Okay, so in this chapter, quantum mechanical chapter, we have 1, 2, 3, 4 question straight away for 8 to 10 marks. 6 marks, 4 to 6 marks concept will be coming from wave nature of particle and as well as significance of the wave. So these are the important concept we are going to see in this module. Okay, one more thing I forget to mention, that this module also includes the numerical problems. And for numerical problems you may expect for 4 marks question, that's it. Okay, so 4 marks question bitre yavade karanakku hechige, not more than this, not less than this, don't expect not more than 4 or not less than 4. So fix 4 marks question from this module. Okay, so let us start with the first introductory part of a quantum mechanics, which we are going to see the black body radiation spectrum. So what is the major problem where we need another branch of physics to solve that problem? So first of all, we'll start with the black body radiation spectrum. So let us consider one body. Obviously it is in black in color. So this body has a nature where it absorb any kind of radiation, any kind of radiation at any angle of incidence. This is an body which absorb any kind of radiation. Any kind of radiation means, for example, light radiation, infrared, IR radiation, X-ray radiation, gamma ray radiation, all these comes under radiation. And these radiation absorbed by this black body at any angle of incidence, for a while this body will increase its body temperature. Okay, when it absorb these radiation with in all direction, then this body temperature will be going to be rise it. And at a certain level, when it reaches, this body will start to eliminate some of its energy in terms of radiation in all direction. So then we used to say that black body radiation. I hope you understand what I tried to say here. ಸೊ ಯಾವುದಾದ್ರೂ ಒಂದು ಬಾಡಿ ತಗೊಳ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀವಿ, ಈ ಬಾಡಿದ ನೇಚರ್ ಏನಿದೆ ಅಂದರೆ ಯಾವುದೇ ಡೈರೆಕ್ಷನ್ನಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾವುದೇ ಟೈಪ್ ಆಫ್ ರೇಡಿಯೇಷನನ್ನು ಅಬ್ಸರ್ವ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋ ಕೆಪ್ಯಾಸಿಟಿ ಈ ಬಾಡಿಗಿದೆ. ಸೊ ಒನ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಅಬ್ಸಾರ್ಬ್ ಆಲ್ ಕೈಂಡ್ ಆಫ್ ರೇಡಿಯೇಷನ್, ದ ಬಾಡಿ ಟೆಂಪ್ರೇಚರ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್. ಟೆಂಪ್ರೇಚರ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿಸ್ ಬಾಡಿ ವಿಲ್ ಗೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಟು ಬಿ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್. ಡ್ಯೂ ಟು ದ್ಯಾಟ್ ರೀಸನ್, ಆಫ್ಟರ್ ಸಮ್ ಟೈಮ್, when it reaches at one certain level, this body will start to eliminate its energy in the form of radiation. That's why we call it as this body, we call it as black body radiation. And by using this black body radiation, here we are trying to keep it in graphical representation. So ಬ್ಲ್ಯಾಕ್ ಬಾಡಿ ರೇಡಿಯೇಷನ್ ಗ್ರಾಫಿಕಲ್ ರೆಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟೇಷನ್ನಲ್ಲಿ ಹೇಳಬೇಕಂದ್ರೆ, ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ವೇವ್ ಲೆಂತ್ ವರ್ಸಸ್ ಇಂಟೆನ್ಸಿಟಿ ಗ್ರಾಫ್. ವೇವ್ ಲೆಂತ್ ವರ್ಸಸ್ ಇಂಟೆನ್ಸಿಟಿ ಗ್ರಾಫನ್ನ ಡ್ರಾ ಮಾಡ್ತಾ ಇದ್ದೀವಿ. ಸೊ ದಿಸ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ವೇವ್ ವಿಚ್ ಈಸ್ ಟ್ರಾವೆಲಿಂಗ್ ಫಾರ್ 1800 ಡಿಗ್ರಿ ಸೆಲ್ಸಿಯಸ್, 2500 ಡಿಗ್ರಿ ಕೆಲ್ವಿನ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ 3000 ಕೆಲ್ವಿನ್. ಫಾರ್ ಅ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಟೆಂಪ್ರೇಚರ್ ವಿ ಹ್ಯಾವ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ವೇವ್. Okay, different types of wave. Now carefully observe, in this, for an 1800 degree Kelvin, the wavelength of width, wave the width is compared with the 2500 degree Kelvin wavelength width. So this wavelength width is going to be reduced with increasing temperature. And now let us see, the width of the wave again reduced with respect to temperature 3000 Kelvin. That means as we are increasing the temperature, the width of the wavelength is going to be decreases. Okay, width of the wavelength is going to be decreases, or we can say like this also, as we are decreasing the temperature, or as we are decreasing the temperature, width of the wave is going to be increasing. This is what we are observed in the case of black body radiation. The problem is, when veins, a person or scientist, and Rayleigh Jeans is also, these are the two scientists, come up and they try to explain, or they said veins give one equation. Okay, and along with this, Rayleigh Jeans relay genes give another equation. We don't need that equation because it is not in your syllabus. We just need to understand why we need, what is the problem we are facing when we use other branch of science equation. Okay, so as per Wien's law, he derived one equation and that equation used to calculate the lambda. At the same time, Rayleigh-Jeans law also derived one equation that is also used to calculate the lambda, and these two results are based on theory or theoretical physics. Okay, so the theoretical physics or theoretical results must be matched with experimental results. Okay, so in physics, whatever the theory explained by the scientist must be matches with practical result. If a theory doesn't match with the practical result, then that theory will be discarded, or it should not be exactly the theory. How, for example, if he said by using one equation, he said I will get 10 degrees Celsius temperature, and in the practical result we are getting 9.5 degree temperature, then also it is acceptable. But nearest value of a practical result will be accepted, but not theoretically calculate madiro value kinta practically calculate madiro value bada difference idre, that theory will be discarded. Okay, now the Wien's come up and he gave one equation that is used to calculate the lambda with respect to temperature T. Okay, and what happens according to Wien's, for a higher temperature in this graph, according to this graph, for a higher temperature means 3000 Kelvin, the lambda which we calculated is exactly same with the theoretical lambda value. But when we decrease the temperature, lambda value or practical result not going to match with the theoretical lambda value. Due to that reason, we said or we discarded Wien's theory, because the lambda values only applicable for higher temperature, not for the lower temperature. And to resolve this problem, Rayleigh-Jeans come up and he give another equation which is also used to calculate the lambda, and this lambda once again is applicable for lower temperature like 1800 degree Kelvin, where we have practically calculated lambda is going to match with theoretical lambda value. When we increase the temperature, at that moment the lambda which we are getting practically is not going to match with theoretical lambda value. Once again we are going to discard with Rayleigh-Jeans law also. Actually, what is the problem they are facing is they thought energy is directly proportional to temperature. Energy is directly proportional to temperature. That means if I want to increase the energy, I need to increase the temperature, or if I want to decrease the energy, I want to decrease the temperature. That's it. So simple, according to Wien's and Rayleigh-Jeans. So by using temperature term, they derived some equation. But the thing is, these two theories is not going to match with this practical results. So that's why we discarded this theory. So to overcome from this problem, Mr. Planck's come up and he said energy is not going to directly proportional with the T. Actually, energy is equal to integral multiple of h into nu. H means Planck's constant, nu means frequency. What he tried to explain is, in a previous concept, they thought because of temperature, all these things are happening. Okay, because avardu tappu yakandre they know only the classical mechanics. Mechanical, classical mechanics, physics, nothing but Newtonian physics. Okay, so classical mechanics always deals with the macro level particle. Macro level particles, like suppose, imagine a car is moving in one direction. We can see this car in which direction is moving. By using this, we can say in this direction the car is under motion. We can find out the direction of that car. We can find out the velocity of the car. We can calculate the time t, at what time it will reach this position, and we can calculate the weight or mass of that car, right? So all the things comes under macro level physics. So that's why temperature is also a classical mechanical quantity. So due to that reason, they thought because of temperature, energy is going to be varied. Because of a variation in energy, lambda is going to be varied. Okay, so when we compared this theoretical explanation with the practical thing, this theory is going to be discarded because this is not going to match with the practical one. Understood? So next, what happens when Planck's come up and he said energy is equal to the integral multiple of h into nu. So as he said, each oscillator has an energy given by integral multiple of h into nu. As I said, h is the Planck's constant, nu is the frequency of vibration. Now what is E equal to h nu? And here n means nothing but E is equals to, if I write exact equation, n into h into nu. As according to Planck's, he said this is not because of temperature, this is because of energy which is supplied by that temperature. For example, he said initially we know that a molecule which has one nucleus and surrounding to this number of orbitals are there, okay, and each orbital may have one electron, right? So now this electron will make a transition from lower energy level to higher energy level, lower energy level to higher energy level. To do that need this much energy. Now what does it n means? N means number of orbital. For example, this is one orbital, second orbital, third orbital, so on. Okay, so this is why he said the energy requirement is very 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 small. Energy requirement is very very small to make a transition from lower energy level to higher energy level. Which particle is making a transition? This is an electron. Electron comes a micro level particle. So that's why we are unable to apply the law which has been proved in a classical mechanics, because classical mechanics mainly deals with the macro level particle. So that's why macro level particle equation should not be applied to micro level particle. So that's why there is a change in a practical result compared to theoretical result with respect to Wien's and Rayleigh Jean's law. Okay, so according to Planck's, he said this much energy is required. Okay, so what does it mean? Each oscillator means, if I simplify this diagram like this, okay, each line we can name it as orbital number 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 and so on. Okay, and each orbital may have 1 electron, 2 electron. Now these are the completely filled orbitals, these are the completely empty orbital or partially filled orbital. Okay, so when we supply that energy E, the outermost orbital electron will absorb that energy and make a transition to the higher state energy level. So for energy requirement is very very small, that's why we coined the term quanta. Means very small. Okay, very small. That's why we have a new branch of physics, we call it as quantum mechanics. This is the new set of branch, we call it as quantum mechanics. I hope you got what I tried to explain it here. By using this equation, he derived this formula where u lambda d lambda is equals to 8 pi hc by lambda raised to 5 into bracket 1 by e raised to h nu by kt minus 1. In this equation you must observe temperature T. Temperature is also a matter, but it is not like as per Wien's and Rayleigh Jean's, energy is not proportional to temperature. Not because of temperature all these things are happening, because of energy we can see that electron can go to the higher state energy level. Okay, this is what we observed in this equation, and as I said, this is also a theoretical equation, and when we compared with the practical situation or practical wavelength value, it is exactly matching for as well as higher value as well as lower value. So due to that reason, we accepted this explanation. That's why Planck is the first person who introduced new branch of science, we call it as, or new branch of physics, we call it as quantum mechanics. I hope all you got what I tried to explain in this video. That's it for today's. We'll see next concept, that is de Broglie hypothesis, what he tried to explain and each and everything. If you like this video, please like it. Or if you don't want to miss any updates which is coming from this channel, please hit the subscribe button, make it red to gray color, and then share it with your friends. With this, let's wrap up the video. Thank you.